spring of 2016, Wendy and I traveled from Colorado to Fort Lauderdale to attend John Kretschmer's offshore sailing clinic, which was, you know, specifically it was a safety-oriented 4-day class that we, it was mostly in the classroom. But one day we did go out on a Lagoon 440 catamaran and deploy PFDs in open water, as well as a Winslow, I think it's a 6-person life raft. And it's a very eye-opening experience to actually jump in the water with a PFD, an inflatable PFD, and climb into an inflated life raft. And you know, nobody practices inflating a life raft because it's so expensive to have the company repack it and recharge it and then recertify it. And it's just something that you don't do with your own life raft. But you know, John got sponsors, and I'm pretty sure Winslow is one of them. And the life raft was just unbelievable and fantastic. So hopefully you'll get a feel for what that's about. This is not an action type video. It's really more of something that if you're serious about offshore sailing, you should be taking safety seriously as well. And that's pretty much what this is about. So I hope you enjoy it, and you know, comment if there's anything that you don't see.
Okay, but the important thing here is when you use a tether, what is really, really essential is that you do not do that. You do not ever put the strong shackle to yourself. Because look at the freeboard on this cat. If you were to fall overboard, nobody's pulling you back up. You have got to release. The snap shackle always knows to you. The strong shackle goes to a strong point on deck. So when you come out of the cockpit, but the reason you have the snap shackle to you is so that when you're overboard, you can release around like this, and you're basically wearing a PFD. These are Coast Guard approved nowadays. They're super flotation. They're dramatically better than the Type 2 and Type 3 old. Valise, you know, sometimes you see they sell them in canisters or valise. Valise is a soft pack. Canister means almost always a fiberglass container. So if you're cruising on your boat, having it in a fiberglass container and you're living aboard makes sense because it protects the raft a lot better. The place to have your life raft mounted is clearly on the stern, and so that you can drop it over the side. The thing is, I was telling you guys, that you don't take them out of this gear. This raft is designed to be dropped like that.
Set them off unless you buy a really expensive one that has a hydrostatic release, and
the manuals you have to deploy yourself, and if you're not conscious or whatever, you know, that's not going to go off. But your odds of survival then are bad anyway. Yeah, exactly. You can knock. Our biggest problem was the inflation. So, you know, I'm kind of a proponent of the manual ones. It just is the way I do
it. What's that? Straightforward, no swinging it? Okay. Ready? One, two, three.
All right, dude. Okay, now start to pull her in. You're going to end up being pulled right up to the boat.
A lot of slack. Okay. So I caught on something.
Going under the boat tonight. Upside down. Happens about half the time. Now you guys can start, get your feet in by the cylinder.
Feet by the cylinder.
Right there. Okay, now start to pull. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's perfect. Right on top of Walter. Excellent. Now you two guys are gonna board it. You're gonna see how hard that is. Your board word says enter here.
Pull it down though, right?
You gotta push that down.
It's Velcro, pull that blue line off.
There you go. Nice.
That's a great raft.
Nice work.
That's a great raft. No, it's a top quality raft.
It's so fair getting the two athletes to do it.
All right, come on in. Okay, those of you with inflated harnesses are going back in the water and you're gonna board it as well.
You away from me. I hope they didn't get your mind.